glad to have you here with us on this Wednesday night edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Moments away, it'll be the Los Angeles Clippers going up against the Dallas Mavericks. Along with Steve Smith and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan. And our friend on the sideline, Hall of Famer David Aldridge, we'll be hearing from shortly. DA, take it away.
Kevin, thank you. There is no question that Dallas's Luka Doncic has captured league-wide admiration. The Hall of Famer player and executive Jerry West said, "We are watching genius, a superstar who will go down as the best player in Mavs franchise history." Considering Dirk Nowitzki was there for a long time, Kevin, the praise from Jerry doesn't get much higher or from a loftier perch.
Indeed, something special, David. Thanks. Deep benches tonight, Greg, on both sides. This seems to be a growing trend.
You know, teams are digging deeper than ever before, even getting into the two-way contracts that give you depth past your top 15 guys. One, you're trying to protect the investment in your big-ticket items, your franchise-caliber players, but you got to keep an eye on the future in terms of player development. That's another area where the league has really changed when you look at the makeup of these rosters.
Well said. Now, a look at Dallas's starting lineup. Finney, Smith, and Porzingis are the forwards. The guard and off guard are Doncic and Hardaway Jr. And it's Powell in at the center. And for the Clippers, the stars of this team on the wing, George and Leonard. Post tandem for him, Morris and Zubac. And it's Beverly in at the point.
You need guys who can stretch the floor or the offense doesn't flow. Paul George is one of the best at it.
Doncic against Beverly. Doncic passes to Porzingis. Lock at six. Hardaway, no good. Now Beverly. And he drives in. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
You see the quickness of Beverly. Blinding speed in the inside.
Doncic passes to Hardaway. Here's the three. And it's Doncic missing. Quick start here for the Clippers in this one. Nobody near George. The three-pointer no good. Dallas has gone 0 of 2 from deep here. Now coming into the league with immense potential, Porzingis has already fulfilled much of it, already an all-star. But you know, Greg, there are still areas he's working on.
Yeah, he's definitely getting stronger and more physical. You'd like to see him make the next pass a little more often when a teammate has a better shot. But if he can just stay healthy, boy, the sky's the limit on what he can accomplish. And it was interesting how the Dallas franchise sold its fans on Doncic. Ownership told him, think of a 6'7 Steve Nash. Isn't quite the shooter Steve was, but is only a teenager. Great vision. Boy, he can really pass it. And it turns out Doncic is all of that and more.
No good on the free throw. And even Nash himself called Doncic a dream prospect.
Yeah, it said Luka was big and mobile enough in the modern game, can guard multiple positions, has a skill set, a winning mentality, and those leadership qualities. Steve Nash sounding like a future GM.
And he sinks the second.
And what's so impressive about Doncic, the maturity. Yes, he's polished, but he's got a completeness to his game at such a young age.
Now, here is George. Pass to Leonard. Now the Mavericks moving it up. Here's Hardaway, and then Hardaway with the dunk.
Excellent on both ends of that play.
Yeah, the steal was sharp, but the slam topped it off.
Turning defense into offense. Every coach talks about it. Perfect example right there.
Pass to Powell. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack. And where's the help defensively?
No excuse. You have to be aware. He should be on your radar all the time.
Doncic with the steal. Powell down low. Working on Zubac. The shot by Powell, no good. And Beverly kicks to Zubac. Pass to Leonard. And here's George for three. Good on the triple. George has got six.
He doesn't need much time to get his shot off. Paul George is a dependable catch-and-shoot option.
The pass to Finney Smith. Shoots over Leonard. Finney Smith can't get it to go.
And I'm sure next time he sits down, coach is going to have a few choice words for him with that shot selection.
And you know what? He knows it. You have to try to play within the system or you're going to come away with empty possessions.
Cranes it from beyond the arc.
And how about the vision there from Doncic? Can make the easy pass and also the difficult one.
Outside Leonard. And Kawhi Leonard with the slam.
Oh, Kev, he put some anger behind that one.
You're telling me. Now here's Hardaway. Doncic outside. Comes up empty from 19 feet out.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
And he uses the glass on the layup.
One of the more physical wings in the league. Kawhi gets smacked there, but not to be denied.
Doncic passes to Powell. To the middle. Here's Porzingis. Powell trying to free himself up. Sinks it, and the shot from Porzingis.
Talented, driven. He puts constant pressure on your defense.
Outside Leonard. Doncic with it. And there's the drive. Count it. Finney Smith's got 5 points so far.
Well, check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates that are clearly on the same
timeout,
page.
Timeout.
And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here. A guy who just continues to earn more minutes. You know, Finney Smith is tough and, Greg, he is effective.
He seems to become a better rebounder every year, more efficient. He'll take charges, commits hard fouls, and I don't think we've seen his ceiling. Finney Smith is a guy you can win with.
Big group substitution here for the Clippers. Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for Zubac. Batum comes in for Morris. Luke Kennard, he's checked in for Leonard. And Reggie Jackson subbed in for Patrick Beverley. Right side Jackson. Mavericks with the rebound. And here's Brunson. And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession. Here's George. He's got six. And Maxi Kleba is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul. Cauley Stein against Ibaka. Pass to Jackson. Six on the shot clock. The Mavericks have gone just a shade under 50% from the field. 5 of 11. Here's Richardson. And that won't go, missing the go-ahead bucket. Redick against Jackson. Outside, George. Ibaka with a screen on Brunson.
Uncontested look. Can't fault the shot selection. He's money from there.
Redick passes to Brunson. Outside, Redick. Good on the three-point shot.
J.J. Redick, very comfortable behind the three-point line. Knocked that one down.
Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum. Yeah, and he had the D tangled up there with that patented crossover. Just couldn't convert the finish.
Now Redick. Paul George missing from long range. Brunson finds Redick. Goes up to the stripe. That one's not going to go. And the Clippers will go the other way with it. 109 left to play here in the first.
George.
They can't stop the run with that one.
You know what, though? They keep calling his number despite the difficult quarter he's had.
And Cauley Stein throws it down.
He's a great shooter, but not just a gunner. JJ finding the open man.
Now here's Jackson, still looking for his first bucket in this one. Kleba with the rebound. Mavericks leading by five. 35 seconds left to play in the first quarter. It's Redick on the wing. Another three for Dallas.
And off to an incredible start here early from long range.
26 seconds left to play in the first quarter. And here's George for three. Kleba with the rebound.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
Brunson kicks to Kleba. Lets it go from deep. That shot, no good. And so it's the Dallas Mavericks in the driver's seat, up 8 points at the end of the quarter. Their defense has been terrific in this game. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Earlier tonight, we spoke with Paul George about how they've integrated all the talent on this team.
Everybody has a chip on their shoulder. Everybody wants to win. And there's no egos. Everybody has fun. We play together. We move the ball. We make sacrifices. And we enjoy getting stops.
Greg, that last point is key. This team plays lockdown defense.
And that's a big part of their identity. Most teams talk about being well-balanced. This team lives it.
And hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half in this one. And a closer look here at the hustle stats for Dallas.
It looks like they're ready to run today, fellas. They keep getting out on the break whenever they can.
Yeah, and one thing, Clark, I've noticed is how quick their hands have been tonight. Thanks to that, they've gotten a lot of points off of turnover.
And a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. On the floor right now for the Mavericks, and the post players for them, Kleba and Porzingis. Doncic out there with Josh Richardson, and it's Hardaway in at the three. Catching up on the changes for Dallas. Dorian Finney-Smith comes in for Maxi Kleba, and it's Burke in for Josh Richardson. Rondo against Doncic. Five to shoot. Fires from deep. Porzingis with the rebound. And so Doncic will bring it up for the Mavericks. Outside Hardaway. Good! And the assist goes to Doncic. Doncic has got three assists now in this one.
They're getting a lot of their points outside the paint. Three of their last five baskets are from three-point range.
Now here's Rondo. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Good!
What passion from Rondo on that drive. Just relentless on how he takes it straight to the defense.
Mavericks leading by 11. And we're now about a minute and a half into the second quarter. And here's Doncic from the arc. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Leonard attacking, and Kawhi Leonard with the slam.
The power, the length, the ability to finish. Leonard dominant in that painted area.
And Smitty, with LeBron getting into his late 30s, KD coming off the Achilles, for your money, is Kawhi Leonard the best player in the world?
Great question. I know one player, the Greek Freak, might have something to say about that. No less than Michael Jordan himself called Kawhi the best two-way player in the game. That's a very strong endorsement from MJ.
Here's Leonard, following the score by Dallas, and it's good, 2 points.
Love the aggressiveness. Kawhi very active, very focused on the job at hand.
Okay. And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. Up top, Burke, defended by Beverly. There's the three. Burke can't get it to go. Clippers trail by 9. Here's Rondo. Pass to Beverly. Here's Cousins. Guarded by Porzingis. Cousins inside. He's against Porzingis.
Shut down. This is the way you play defense. This is how you protect the rim.
Now Burke, outside Hardaway. With the drive. Can't hit from in close. For Los Angeles, they've gone 50% from the floor in the second quarter, 3 of 6.
Yeah, but the hand in the face. It's critical that you contest his shots every time down the floor.
A second chance effort. That one misses. And it's the Clippers taking it the other way. And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Kevin, good evening. The Clippers were picked by many to win the title last year. Now, they didn't get it done, but Kawhi Leonard is not concerned. He said, we've just got to keep getting better, keep fighting. It's about the right team peaking at the right time. Guys are hoping this season their talent and their fight will win out. Back to you.
We will see. Good stuff, DA. Thanks. Here is Rondo after Luka Doncic's bucket. Here's Cousins. Back to Beverly. An easy 2 points on the layup. Beverly's got his second basket of the night.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Doncic outside. The three. In it goes. That's his third bucket. He's missed 5 so far.
And love how much Doncic believes in himself. It shows when he shoots off the pass like that.
And it's a completely new group for Los Angeles. Dallas also making some changes. Cauley-Stein, he's checked in for Dorian Finney-Smith. Reddick comes in for Burke. And it's Jalen Brunson in for Hardaway. Reggie, we hear this a lot. It's almost too popular now to say good offense beats good defense. Being a defensive-minded player yourself, do you agree with that statement?
Absolutely, Kevin. And the thing is, in today's game, when I played, there was an era, you know, you could hold teams in the 80s and 90s. You could go a quarter and keep them at 12, 15 points. You can't do that now. It's different. You've got to be able to win stretches of 2 and 3 minutes. And honestly, you're right. The offense does dictate far more, but it doesn't discount the importance of defense. And if you still look at the reigning champs and the teams that have won titles recently, that's still one area that they're consistent in is their defensive approach.
The Mavericks have gone 1 for 2 on the night so far from the line. And the Mavericks with some changes. Maxi Kleba comes in for Porzingis. And Josh Richardson subbed in for Doncic.
Cauley-Stein has drawn comparisons to Tyson Chandler due to his length and athleticism. It's important he continues to get better.
Now, here is George. He's got 6. Zubac, the pass to Jackson. There's the drive. It's rebounded by Brunson. Mavericks leading by 13. Passes it to Richardson. Over George. Richardson, good. Richardson's got his first 2 points.
I like that Josh Richardson is more comfortable in this offense, just taking what the defense allows.
Here's George. Throws it down as the official calls the foul. It may be a 3-point play. It's going to go on Willie Cauley-Stein.
And wait to finish and cut into that lead a little bit.
Yeah, but look at the basket guy still shaking.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
Now, throw good, Paul George.
In OKC, Paul George showed he could be an MVP-caliber performer. With Kawhi on the Clippers, he could be that 1B or that 1A.
Now here's Brunson. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. And George kicks to Batum. Driving to the basket, and the shot goes in. Batum's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And PG, you know, he has the versatility to succeed in different roles. Doesn't have to dominate the ball.
Yes, and if anything, he's more comfortable scoring within the flow of the offense. With his all-around impact, doesn't need to force things to make winning plays. But if you need him to, he can.
And it's Batum with the ball, bringing it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. Redick against George.
Well, he was in rhythm, hitting 2 threes in the opening quarter, but hasn't made one since.
54 seconds left to play in the first half. Brunson, good.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Hey, yo, right here.
Ibaka with a screen on Richardson.
And they've only got a slight edge on the boards, but it just feels a lot bigger.
It's deflected. Now, here's George. There's the pass to Ibaka. The dish now to Jackson. Richardson with it. The three. No good on the last second attempt there. And that concludes the first half. Mavericks lead by 12. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks a lot, Kevin. DeMarcus, you guys have had chances, but you haven't taken advantage of those chances. What do you say to the team?
That's something I've been preaching on. They're giving us a lot of opportunities, and we got to do something with it. So hopefully we can keep them missing shots and we can get something out of it.
We'll see what happens in the second half. Thanks, DeMarcus. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, thank you, David. And folks, don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number three.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Program. I'm Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. And the Mavericks over the past couple of years, Shaq, making some great personnel moves.
Look, they traded up to get Doncic. They traded Dennis Smith Jr. In a package deal, and they got the great Porzingis.
Yeah, I mean, exciting young core. They're adding pieces around him and Doncic and around the franchise. Man, they're primed.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final.
Horn. Oh, buzzer.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. Without question, George is displaying his skills today.
Well, we'll find out if they were able to find an answer for him over the break. He was scoring with ease in that first half.
I think both sides probably adjusted a few things. The key for him is to bring the same level of energy over these last two quarters.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. Leonard and Morris are up in the forward positions. The guard set is Beverly and George. And it's Zubats in at the five, roaming the paint. So that's the lineup on the floor for the Clippers.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
And here's Beverly. Nice D from Doncic. He takes it in. Oh. Pounds of Hardaway. It's up a three. Sinks the triple. Hardaway has got the first basket of the second half here for the Mavs.
I love that they're continuing to attack despite being up big.
I'm impressed with their intensity tonight. They've came in focused and they've executed.
Now, here is George. 9 points in the game so far. Beverly wide open. Trying to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. And with a little over a minute gone, the second half is underway. Hardaway against George. Back to Doncic. And here's Porzingis for a three. And it's the Clippers with the rebound. George passes to Leonard. Over in the corner, Beverly. The Clippers rebound. Back to Leonard. Outside for George. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. George has got 12.
I mean, a great look by Kawhi, aware of what the defense is trying to do. Understands the spacing.
No one near Doncic as he lets it fly. No good from outside. Clippers trail by 12. George looking over the floor. Takes the three. The Mavericks pull it in. Doncic has got his fifth rebound in this one. Driving inside.
And when you want Doncic, he's one of those guys who kind of just slithers around until he finds an opening, and then bam.
Here's George. He's got 12. Leonard sets a screen for George. And it's Leonard, top of the key. And he makes that one. He's got 10.
You know he's pulling his weight, but they still find themselves behind.
And guys, even though he's in a big market, Kawhi Leonard still not one for the spotlight.
That is so true. It's not about the fame for him. He's in L.A., but Kawhi Leonard stays in his bubble. All the trappings that come with being a great player, he's truly focused on the love of the game, winning and being the best possible player he can be.
Mavericks leading by 14. Little under 2.5 minutes off the clock now here in the third. Drives to the hoop, and he bangs it home with one hand.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish. Now here's Leonard. He's got 10.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Pass to Finney Smith. Pulls up. Morris with the rebound. Morris has got 4 rebounds now tonight. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Powell against Zubac. Now Beverly. Outside, George launches it. Nice D from Doncic.
Their game plan needs to change if they're going to get out of this hole because he is just not there offensively.
Morris with the rebound. Morris has got his 5th rebound right now in the game.
No other way to put it. Just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack. You know, fought hard from start to finish on that play. Defended the shot and then finished it off with the rebound.
They blow the whistle just as he gets it off. That's 2 points with a chance for another one at the stripe. And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Mavericks.
What tremendous passing we've seen from them today. A very unselfish performance all around.
And also, how about the points they've gotten in transition or on the fast break tonight? That's been a huge factor as well.
And it's a completely new group for Los Angeles. Dallas also making some changes. Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for Powell. Richardson comes in for Hardaway. And it's Jalen Brunson in for Dorian Finney-Smith. That free throw good from Doncic. Well, it seems like every year, Greg, we see some incredible new players come to the NBA, and they are welcome with open arms. Their style of play is so terrific.
No doubt about it. You know, guys like Ja Morant, I think he's got a chance to be one of the greats. And any list about the future of the NBA has to include Luka Doncic. I don't know if there's a better basketball talent than that young man. And, you know, let's not forget about Devin Booker out in Phoenix as well. A terrific, terrific player.
Three terrific kids. You're right. And he's got his first free throw of the game.
And last season, he was successful. 81% of the time when he went to the line, so he didn't waste a lot of opportunities.
Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good.
Cauley-Stein, he's checked in for Dallas.
And he makes both free throws. Clippers trail by 21. Rondo kicks to Ibaka. He dishes it to Jackson. Ibaka with a screen on Richardson. Shot clock at 6. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
And at his peak, Reggie Jackson is one of the better guards in the league. He still got that confidence.
Yes, he does. Injuries slowed him down, but still able to create his shot anytime he wants.
That free throw, no good.
You know, he was the 24th pick in 2011. I think it's safe for us to say Jackson's outplayed that draft slot.
And the Mavericks making a change here. Porzingis has checked in. And the second free throw, good. Now the Mavericks with it. They're on a 14-6 run. Now here's Brunson. Pass to Kleba. Here's Doncic. Again, the miss by the Mavericks.
Everything worked except for the outcome. You want him to shoot that every time.
The drive by Rondo. That one goes. Count it. Rondo's got his second bucket of the night.
Really admire the fact that Rondo is not afraid to go down there in the paint from time to time.
Doncic left side. And he makes good on the layup. Doncic has got 7 points here in this quarter.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And the Clippers call time here.
Yeah, and his shot selection, iffy at best tonight. A lot of forced, contested shots this game. He'll be lucky if he just gets a talking to here instead of a ticket to the bench.
In the corner, Ibaka with it. Back to Rondo for the three. Mavericks with the rebound. Porzingis has got his seventh rebound here tonight.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
And that one, good.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
Now here's Rondo. Passes to Batum. Kennard with the ball. He kicks it to Jackson. Five on the clock. Here's Rondo. Drains the three-pointer. Rondo's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Rondo from outside? How about that?
Takes it inside. Brunson against Rondo. Puts it up from 12. Doncic, no good.
Come on, that's your bread and butter. You can't miss that.
Doncic against Rondo, and it's in there. Rondo's got 9.
If you give him an inch of space, he's going to make you pay.
It's a 4-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Doncic outside, a 3-ball. The Clippers grab the miss.
Hasn't been able to dial it in from distance. He has just the 1-3, and that was in the first half.
Here's Jackson. That one falls.
The aggressiveness of Jackson, able to drive and convert against tight defense.
He made it! Yes. He made it!
Yes, he did!
Yeah. Wow. That's a miracle. Are you kidding me?
I didn't think that shot had any chance of going in. Just shows you that anything can happen in this game.
It's been all about Luka Doncic for Dallas. He got into double digits for the quarter with 10 points total. We'll return shortly. And with the fourth quarter upon us, time is running out for this game to become competitive. And here's George. He'll bring it up for Los Angeles. They trail by 18. On the floor for Dallas, Richardson is out there with Hardaway. Then there's Maxi Kleber. Then there's J.J. Redick. And it's Finney Smith in at the foreshot.
The decision-making of Leonard could have hit the roller, but already had the shot he wanted.
And here are the Mavericks now. The Clippers getting the bucket. Outside Hardaway. Misses the three. And here is Los Angeles now. And here's George. Can't cash in from close range. Dallas leading by 16. Richardson outside for three. It's hauled in by Zubats. Zubats has got 5 rebounds tonight.
You know what? They're winning, though, despite the fact that he has just been really off.
Leonard dishes to George. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Leonard's got 4 assists now tonight.
Hey, continue to stack it up from 3. He's got 2 in each half so far.
Richardson gets a wide-open look. An absolute bomb from 3-point range. And the Mavericks lead by 16. Just about 1.5 minutes gone by here in the fourth. Jackson misses. Dallas has gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Here's Richardson. The 19-foot shot. Jump shot is good.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
The Clippers have gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Here's Jackson. A shot off that time. Good work defensively by Richardson.
The struggle is real. He's been way off with his shot all evening long.
Outside, Redick fires the three. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Ibaka's got his 5th rebound in this one. Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. Jackson against Hardaway. Clock at 4. Here's Leonard. Los Angeles with another miss. Mavericks leading by 18. Richardson up top, defended by George. Richardson kicks to Hardaway. No good, shot missing. So the Clippers will take it the other way. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket. And you can tell he's looking for his shot. He just believes in it.
You know why? Success breeds confidence. And he's certainly been successful from there, time and time again.
Now, here's Redick. And misses it off the right side of the rim. George passes to Leonard. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Leonard's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And he's really shot the ball well, but it hasn't been contagious.
Marcus Morris is checked in for the Clippers. Patrick Beverley comes in for Reggie Jackson. Dallas also making some changes. Powell, he's checked in for Maxi Kleba. Porzingis comes in for J.J. Redick. And Luka Doncic subbed in for Josh Richardson. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, I heard Rick Carlisle during that last break talking with the team. His point to them was that they put themselves in a position to succeed and that this is their game to lose. So he needs to see full concentration out of every guy on the court to finish this one off. Kevin?
Thank you, David. And Morris throws it down.
And when he's aggressive, watch out. Morris finishing through the contact, now going to the line to try and add one more.
You know, winning that championship as you did, Greg, for UNLV, many people don't remember you played much of that season with a broken jaw.
Well, Kevin, I don't remember much of it, to be honest with you. It was pretty hazy. I lost 19 pounds over the course of the season.
Oh,
I was
goodness.
Championship night, I was 168 pounds.
No
and,
kidding.
Yeah. Well, I was wired shut for 8 weeks. Did miss a game, but I tell you what, I don't know if I would do that today, but you know, it did turn out well with the championship.
As I recall, you broke it against Fresno State, correct?
Yes, yeah. Got my legs taken out from under me and broke the fall with my face.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, ouch. Now here's Leonard. After Luka Doncic's miss, shoots over Powell. No good there, and that would have cut it to single digits. Mavericks leading by 10. Out to Doncic. Hardaway from outside. Good. And the assist goes to Doncic. Doncic has got 6 assists in the game.
He is starting to build up a little confidence. Hit just 1 3 in the entire first half, but he has hit 2 more since then.
Now, here is George driving the lane, and George with the stuff.
So far, George's competitive play has worked well. He's getting just about everything to fall.
on the wing, Doncic. Defended by Beverly. And he overdid it there. Too much force, it looked like, on the foul, and he's called for the flagrant.
Boy, a very hard foul that time, and the officials had to slap him with the flagrant. I mean, you can't let him get Shoot away two. With that kind of contact.
Yeah, gee, that's an easy call for the officials to make when there's that much contact. The league is really cracking down on those sort of plays. That free throw missing. It's the second from the line.
And they didn't shoot it very well from the line in the first half, but they've gotten much better since halftime, and it's helped them to secure the lead.
Clippers trail by 12. Leonard attacking. He watches it go through the hoop for his eighth make. Now 8 for 14.
Pushing the action. Always working for the best shot. Nice drive by Kawhi.
Beverly against Doncic. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the D.
Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. Free throw is good from Doncic. And so it's Leonard with it. He'll bring it up for the Clippers. On his 15th shot attempt, he makes his ninth basket. Shooting a healthy 60% tonight.
He's been locked in all night, and he's taking good shots.
And now, a moment to present the New Balance Player of the Game, Luka Doncic.
And to me, the best part of his game has been the work he's done inside. I mean, slashing, driving the lane, attacking the basket at every chance. When he's had an opening, he's taken it.
He silenced this crowd with an unreal display. His ability to drown out the noise and the hostility of an opposing crowd is pretty special. .156 left in the fourth quarter. It's hauled in by Beverly.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
From deep, George. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. George has got it back down to within single digits for the Clippers. Maverick shooting 43% from the field. Outside Hardaway. Here's Powell. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
Oh, and look at how well he led him in there. Really, he passed him open for that deuce.
Good. Clippers trail by 9. Leonard with the ball. Now guarded by Porzingis. Porzingis with the block.
And with his length, Porzingis can be very disruptive on D. Not easy to get the shot off over that huge frame.
Now here's Doncic. Now the pass to Finney Smith. Offensive rebound. Los Angeles has gotten off to a great start from three-point range in the final quarter. They're a perfect 3 of 3. There's 47 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Pass to Hardaway. Outside, Porzingis. No good on the three. And here's Los Angeles. Pass to Leonard. On the shot and picks up 2 points, so one free throw coming up.
You see the power right there from Kawhi. Absorbs contact and able to convert right through it.
Three seconds left in the game, and that's an intentional foul.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Gets the first, and that makes it a 7-point lead. And he hits both free throws here, so now it's an 8-point game. And the Clippers call time here. They're behind by 8. We've got 22 seconds left to play in the final quarter. What do you think, guys?
And I don't think they'll be able to climb out of this hole.
I just think they have to focus on the moment. Don't worry about the score. Worry about executing the next play.
From deep, George, it's in! Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5.
And he's just living out beyond the arc right now. What a weapon to have on the floor.
This is when they need it the most, so they're so close to evening this game up.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. 20 seconds left in the fourth. And now we've got the intentional foul.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
He drops the first one, and that increases their lead to six. Second one is good. Getting both at the line, and it's a 7-point game.
Productive trip to the line extended their lead.
And here's George for three. Good! And now they trail by just four.
Just a humongous fourth quarter for him, especially from long range. Just in a groove now, and that tray has been deadly.
Yeah, you can't let him hold the ball and just milk those last seconds away.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
He doesn't hit the first, and that was the one they really wanted. He's got one more, though. He's able to hit the second one, and that puts them up by five. From outside the arc, knocks down the trifecta.
One thing we know about Beverly, he plays with a lot of confidence. Believes every shot is going in.
And there's the intentional foul. No choice but to stop the clock here.
Shoot two.
Good on the first, and that makes it a 3-point lead. He's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in.
And it's all about the three right here.
And they're looking to tie it up. Live to play another period. We'll see what they run right here.
And he commits the intentional foul.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
the first free throw, missing for him. We'll see if he can nail the second. So he can't get either to fall. So it's a narrow victory for the Mavericks, pulling out the W. They break the hearts of every fan in the building with a dramatic late victory.
And Kevin, this is the kind of win you have to take a ton of pride in. I mean, they battled with everything they had and came through when the pressure was at its highest.
And we've got David Aldridge standing by on our sideline with the player of the game. David, it's all yours.
Hey, Kevin, thank you. Here with Luka. You got the W, so what did you think about your performance?
You know, we got a win against team that is very competitive. You know, they go hard no matter what. You know, they're a great team, and you know, I'm just glad we got a win. We got to keep going like that.
Hey man, thanks for your time. I really appreciate it. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. Now for Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge. This is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA here on 2K Sports, and we'll see you next time.